sacre Florida song. Oh, I'm free. Praise the Lord. Free and land. Oh, I am free. Free from the fear of tomorrow. Oh, I am free from the key. Oh, my God. Oh, I have changed myself. Oh, for the glory, I am free. Praise the Lord, free and land. Oh, I am free. I am free from the fear. Oh, 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 I am free from the fear. Oh, my God. For the glory, I am free. I am free. Oh, can we testify one more time? He and land. Oh, I am free from the fear. Worship him this morning. Blessed be his mighty name. Oh, we are free, amen, from all sin and doubt, amen. Blessed be your wonderful name, Lord. Oh, we adore you, Lord God, this morning, Father. We give you all the praise that you rightfully deserve, Lord. Blessed be your wonderful name, Lord Jesus. King of kings, Lord of lords, you are, Lord. King Melchizedek, Lord Father, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We worship you, Lord God. Blessed be your wonderful name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be your wonderful name, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, you worship him. Blessed be his name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be your wonderful name, Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus, what a wonder you are. You are brighter than the morning star. You are fairer. Ah, than the lily that fades away. You are precious, most precious, precious, sweet Jesus, sweet. amen. Let me step forward, my brother, amen. Open this meeting with a word of prayer, amen. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise, amen.
Shall we bow our heads in a word of prayer? Yes. Almighty God, yes, indeed, this morning, you are precious. You are fairer than all, Lord Jesus. You are the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. Lord God, you raise us up out of nothing, Lord, out of the dust of the earth, Lord, and you're ready to pour your glory into us, Father. Oh God, as angels, Lord, are rejoicing in heaven, Father, because they know on the earth, Lord, there's a pride that has thus saith the Lord, Father. There's a pride that is the final voice to the final age, Father. All the attraction this morning is in the Milner, Lord, a little group coming together, Lord. Lord, Father, brought together by the seven seals, the seven thunders, the seven stars, the seven messengers, Lord God, the seven manifestations of the Holy Spirit, Lord, through seven church ages, the seven thunders. That's the thunder that will shake the devil's kingdom, Father. And this morning, the devil, Lord, knows he has to leave this building for, because he knows when the pride connects with the headstone, Father, it will be over, Father. So this morning, Father, may the headstone move among us, Father. May you come in the building, Lord, that mighty angel with the swept back wings, Father, that powerful angel, may you sweep through here, Father, from heart to heart, from seat to seat, Father. May you touch everybody that came in here this morning. We need to see the glory of the Lord, Father, made manifest this morning. Bless the minister who's going to preach the word, Father. We know, Lord, you can do anything, Father. May you step into his 16 element this morning, anoint the song leader, Father, to take us into higher heights, into deeper depths, Father. When the word is preached, Father, we'll be ready to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. All the shackles is already broken, Father. May we be in one accord. Bless the song leaders, Lord, the tithes and offerings, Father, the musicians. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes, give the Lord a praise, amen. Blessed be his wonderful name, amen. Hallelujah. May turn around, amen. Be your brother, amen. Be your sister, amen. Blessed be his wonderful name. Somlande lu Jesu. Somlande la yonke indawo. Somlande la somlande. Jesus, oh mase pina som lande la, ah som lande, som lande la yo pina oh som. La som lande Jesu no seya pina som lande la lande la som lande Jesu oh som lande la yo hinda ho som. Let's go to the place, amen. Hallelujah. Blessed be his wonderful name. Amen. Hallelujah. Turn around one more time. Amen. Give the brother next to you. Amen. Welcome everyone in the house of the Lord. Amen. We are glad to be found in his presence this morning. Lizali City Gala Ako Chikongo Ie Nyani So So Gita Gaso Kizi Iswe Masizu Sehu at saints, amen. Hallelujah. As a brother, amen. Prepare to come forward, amen. Hallelujah. Sing abahamba yotina kulom laba siye kaya eka yesu sing abahamba yotina kulom laba siye kaya eka yesu siti leka Yesu singaba hamba yo tina bukonga tina siye leka Yesu sitiane ale haleluya sitiale 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 haleluya oh sitiale 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 haleluya sitiale 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 haleluya oh sitiale 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 haleluya Wakanaka, wari wakanaka, wari wakanaka, oh wakanaka, oh wakanaka, wari wakanaka, oh wari wakanaka, oh wari wakanaka. Wakanaka, oh wakanaka, oh ma, wari wakanaka, oh ma, wari wakanaka, oh ma, wari wakanaka, wakanaka. Praise, amen. Let's be on a full name, maybe seated saints, amen. Hallelujah. Do I appreciate the Lord this morning? Let's be on a full name. Hallelujah. We have testimonies, amen. Hallelujah. Brother Mbuso, Brother Paul Papizo, and Brother Tali, amen. Hallelujah. I'm just going to start with a precious brother, Brother Mbuso. May you come forward, my brother. Let's give on a of praise, amen.
Sibonga inkosi, amen.
Brother Zotolika le ndithi time inkosi, khazotolika inkosi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ndiyani bulisa bangcwele kuseni.
I greet you all the saints this morning.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Ekama lenkosi yethu Jesu Christ.
Ndizokucula.
I'm about to sing.
Andizokucula mkhonzi.
Oh, I'm not going to sing. So.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But ndiza ndinenhliziyo enombulelo kuseni.
I come with a very appreciating heart this morning.
Amen. Hallelujah. Abe sithe sa nesehlo sokulahlekelwa ngu anti wethu ekhayeni.
When we
sokushiywa ngu anti ekhayeni, when our aunt passed away.
Yes, amen.
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 Sawunyamezelana bakhonzi, amen.
Amen.
Ukusuka emazantsi enhliziyo yami ndifuna ukuzothi enkosi.
From the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you all saints.
Ndifuna ubula bangcwele khange ndiyilindele inkxaso esesayifumana izolo.
It was something that I did not expect yesterday.
Amen. I know it takes a lot.
Ndiyazi ithatha okuninzi.
That the saints of God will dig in their pockets.
Kuba bangcwele bakhuphe kwipokothi zabo.
And put fuel.
Bagalele ipetroli.
And travel about 500 kilometers.
Bambi 500 kilometers konke usuke ezindlini zabo
just to go and support us.
Babemke bayondixhasa.
Bangcwele, it means a lot to us.
Ifuneka okuninzi kuthi bangcwele.
It means a lot to us, amen.
Ithetha okuninzi kuthi
as a family, amen.
Ngokomndeni.
It means a lot to me.
Ithetha okuninzi kum
as a brother in the local church.
And
I would like to encourage the saints of the living God that something like that, amen, that we continue to do it to each and everyone. You do not understand the impact it has to our families when they see the believers gathering around us. That is my prayer, that the Lord will continue to reveal such not only to me, but that we will be able to support one another. And I'm standing here to say thank you for your prayers. And I was listening yesterday, the prophet of God says in the book that says the days of our lives,
he
says the Christian life is a continuous sacrifice. It is joy to sacrifice. It is a joy to worship the Lord. And I want to encourage the dear pastor that God will bless him. I want to just say thank you in the absence of our dear brother Edward. Sister Edward, please pass my regards to him. That I really appreciate him, amen. And the brothers, brother Colin and them that phoned me, that could not make it, amen. Please, my dear sister, pass my regards.
My sister, and
everyone that came through for us yesterday. May God richly bless you. And even above all, Pastor, God worked miraculously yesterday that he allowed the pastor that was conducting the
service,
that the pastor asked our dear brother Pumzile and our dear pastor just to say a word of encouragement. Saints, you cannot understand the impact that short exaltation did to the saints of God. It just broke my heart just to see the hunger and the thirst from the people. It was indeed a great response.
Yes.
It was indeed a great response. Amen. It was a great response, feedback from the people. And to me, as an individual, I realized that it is wonderful for us to gather like this. But there is a great commission.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
That the word of the Lord can go out,
yes,
and be preached to those hungry souls.
Amen.
May God. Once again, I want to thank everyone. Amen.
Amen.
That spent their substance yesterday to go and support us. May God richly, richly bless you all.
Amen. Amen.
Amen, amen. Let's give a little hand of praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Paul, God bless you, my brother.
Amen. Greetings to the bride of the living God. Amen. Amen. I'm standing here with a grateful heart. Because we see our God in very little things. You know, just a short testimony. I have an attitude when it comes to wallets. Because what happens when you lose it, you lose almost everything. But a friend of mine, when it was my birthday, bought me this. It's a card holder. I happened to lose it during the week, last week. You know, I was so troubled. I didn't even pray those sincere prayers. You know those. you know those prayers that you promise God that if I can find it, Lord, I will serve you. I was just troubled, you know. I told Zoe's teacher that I might have dropped it maybe when I was dropping Zoe at school. She promised that she will look for it. The following day I went to school just to cut the long short. When I was at work I had to go and fetch my laptop in the car. I opened the driver's door. And I opened the one behind the driver. A thought or a word said to me, you know, most God can return that card holder. Just that you don't believe. I thought, no, it's just a thought, man, you know. I let it pass because I've trained myself that if I lose something, that it's lost. I must find it within me to just forget about it. Not to worry about it. So I went to the boot, I opened the boot. There this car holder was in the plane. You know what the devil does?
He
wants to steal my testimony now. He says, no man, this thing was there.
Just
that you didn't look thoroughly. I said, no man, it wasn't there because my father visited us during the week, so he wanted a form of some sort that was in the boot. So I went to look that form there. So there is no way that I could have missed it. Because it was in the plain view.
That's why Satan, I've been deeply lying.
I started to share the testimony. This is not the only testimony where I lose something and I pray to God and He returns it.
And
you know, it's not good to lose something.
Doesn't
feel well.
No,
the devil said, no, I'm going to get this one. He thinks that God returns things that he have lost. On Friday, my wife was away in a school excursion. Then when she returned back, I locked there, so I had to fetch her.
I was
with Zoe and Pilar, then I locked the door. We don't have a spare key. Then we went to fetch her. When we got back, we couldn't find the key, and we don't have a spare key. And the devil is saying to me, yeah, let your God return it. You said your God is returning things. You know, I was so calm. It happened that the front door was unlocked. And I told them, lock, get in front. We're going to sleep tonight. We're not going to lock the gates and stuff. We're just gonna let it God and protect us. Gonna let God protect us.
We slept.
Then when I woke up,
went
to open the gate. When I got to the car,
stuck under the
my God is always returning my lost stuff.
So,
it might look as something petty, but our prophet teaches us that He follows after our lost things. He makes an example like those police dogs. That's how he looks after our lost stuff.
If he can
look after our lost things, he can look after our lost souls.
Amen.
I'll just sing one verse, my brother. If you can help me, if you can give me a C. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend there.
Amen. May come forward.
God bless you, saints. I greet you all in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus
Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Yesterday we went to support our precious
brother Mbuso.
In Sterkspruit.
Sterkspruit.
So a couple of weeks back, was thinking, this brother is always supporting everyone in this church. And the devil says, but you don't have money. How are you going to put fuel in your car? So I phoned my precious brother, Willie James.
Yes,
brother Willie James, I really love to support my brother. Can't we ask the pastor just to accompany him? Since we don't have money. Although we do have. We have problems with our little faith. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, so by the grace of the Lord, the pastor gave us feedback. But the Lord already had a plan for this whole trip. He already knew that me and Brother Nathaniel we're going to talk about this permissive will and this perfect will of God. And we're going to debate there in the back seat. And then he's going to come down and demonstrate the miraculous unfolding. Amen.
Amen.
So we were on the way there driving. And we attended the service. And as Brother Mbuso said, even God knew that man was going to ask the man of God to say something. Oh, Brother Pumzile. And our precious pastor.
No pastor.
And it's true, the people were hungry. And their response was amazing. Because they're not used to this food, most. From the golden pot. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And on our way back, the Lord says, okay, you've been talking about permissive and perfected will. I'm just going to show you something now. We went to the toilet then to buy a drink. And while I was in the restroom, I was panicking. I must be quick. Because I've already delayed the guys then Sterkstrom. I don't want to delay them again. You know, my phone was dead, so I asked the sister to charge the phone. And then after the brethren went already to the car, I went to go and request the phone, and the sister fetched the phone while everybody was waiting for me. So I rushed out of the restroom. We jumped into the car and we drove. About 10 k's outside of Cathcart. I realized I don't have my phone. And I think, my assignments, my schoolwork, everything is here. My recordings of the teachings and the preachings is here. My personal notes is here. And fear came upon me. But before the fear came, I said to the pastor, pastor, it seems like I've forgotten my phone there. And the pastor just drive cool and calm.
And the pastor
and I'm like, I was expecting some brakes now. I was expecting maybe a pullover for a U-turn now. But the pastor is driving cool and calm. And this fear is coming upon me. Oh, but that small voice inside of me also starts to preach. And he says, only believe. Only believe. And the pastor said, no.
What you, pastor? Aye.
Oh, brother Lubabalo is behind us.
Oh, brother Mzalanwethu Lubabalo ungemva kwethu.
Yo, our God is amazing, man.
Amen.
Oh, he knows everything.
Amen.
From the beginning. Yes. Okay, my brother. So, pastor phone, oh, brother Lubabalo. And he explained him, where did we turn into? The name of the place. Meanwhile, I was still speaking to this jacket. This jacket just wants us to worry and be nervous and be afraid. But the Lord even saw that this jacket don't want to learn, and the Lord spoke through pastor.
Amen.
And the pastor said, this man of faith sitting in front, he said, now you're going to see what my God will do. Now you're going to see what my God will do. He said, you and brother Nathaniel, you were speaking about permissive and perfect will, going back and forth as if you don't know what you're talking about. Now God is going to show you exactly.
Yeah.
When brother Lubabalo phoned us, he said, no, there's no phone here. This
toilet.
Hey, my bike was shaking. The brother went out. The pastor said, you must go back. Amen. Go back and look again. You know, and we found the phone while the brother was there. We didn't know that sister was lying. That sister that was working here, she was not being honest. She didn't tell the truth. But needless to say, the Lord knew that the captain of the police, he must be behind us, not in front of us.
Amen.
He must go there and find that phone. And the brother found the phone. It was hidden. It was a mystery.
Amen.
The brother found the phone. I'm telling you, there was an excitement that broke out in that car. Brother Duke in the Daniel. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Dudley, the pastor. We were so celebrating because we knew it was more than just a phone. It was our God showing us that everything is under His control, and that we must believe Him and we must trust Him. We must trust the Lord with everything, with our whole lives. With our jobs, with our children, with our unconverted family, we must believe God. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
With our substance, amen.
Amen.
Let's give the Lord a hand of praise, amen. Do I appreciate Brother Dudley, amen? Hallelujah. Do I appreciate Brother Wellington, amen? Hallelujah. Let's all rise, amen, as we want to welcome the brother, amen, just to give us a song, amen. Let's go and praise, we turn around, amen. Greet your brother, greet your sister.
Saints, I just want to say, the brother says, the full man!
Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. 1, 2. Praise the Lord. I greet the saints in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, of whom to know is life eternal this morning. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Masibu lele ku Yesu gokuba wasifila oma senti la yesebe gokosi fela kwa Takuba wo takuba wo hebanu Fefeku Takuba wo Takuba wo Takuba wo Hebanu Fefeku Masimu lele Masimu lele kuye Gokuba wa sefe wa senzela kosiam hoko kose fela akutako akuna wotako ohe manho ay ay andinibo bazalwane Takuba wo, ay basalwane, oh hiba no, fe, si mo 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 mo, si mo mo, si mo wo wo, si wo 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 wo, enkosiam, si wo 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 wo.
Oh, see you. city, city, oh city. Hey! know when you serve the Lord. Gas kom nika yonke into man. Gee die Here alles. Pastor, Madam Buso, you may step forward. Dim ding ding dim gaga. Tumelele dim ding ding. Dim ding ding dim gaga. Dim ding ding dim ka. Tumelele. Tumelele.
Thank you. Tell your brother next to you, I don't know about you, but I know one thing. The Lord helped me. The Lord helped me. Just take your neighbor's hand. I don't know about you, but the Lord helped me. I know something. God helped me. God redeemed me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You may be seated.
Blessed
be the name of the Lord.
God is great.
Hallelujah.
God is great.
Civil.
We've
heard.
God returns the wallets. God returns the wallets. God returns the cell phones.
Hallelujah.
God can return even the soul of man.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Utiko angabuisa imphefumulo womntu.
God can return the soul of man.
And that's why we're here this morning. That God can speak to our souls. We are blessed. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Amen.
Yesterday, when we drove here, just before this cell phone got lost, Brother Virgil and myself were fellowshipping over the phone. And the brothers were just quiet, listening to our conversation. And our conversation was about dominion. And 10 minutes later, what we speak, God brings a manifestation. Dominion. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I told the brothers, I don't know about you. Today, you're going to see God. I don't fast and pray when I'm in a problem. I fast and pray before the problem. I told them, today you're going to see the results of fasting and praying.
Amen.
And the brother said, I don't see the phone. I like Elijah. Go back again. When he went back again,
and he said, Pastor, I saw the phone.
All of a sudden, there is a rejoicing that happens in the
car.
Man. Now, Brother Dougie and Brother Dudley, they were at one another's head.
Umzalwane ke uNathaniel nomzalwane uDudley bebambene ngobhongwane.
You know, most in the message, sometimes you get that thing. Everyone wants to say his story and this one wants to say his story. And I hear the back here, tell me the definition. And then they were speaking about permissive will and perfect will. And it was rough here at the back. Apparently the deacon had to interfere. As our brothers, when you fellowship, man, you don't have to prove your point. Hey, meanwhile, these two were talking something they don't know. And God, on the way back, he said, I'm going to show you the true definition of permissive will and perfect will. God permit Brother Dudley to lose his phone, but his perfect will glorified his permissive will. Hallelujah.
Amen. The child wanted to steal the phone.
Satan.
And God told the devil.
Satan.
Satan.
You
just remove it from its position.
And
you hide it elsewhere.
When others
want to use the bathroom so that they won't see it.
Ewe itat.
Take it.
Ka ungayi.
But don't remove.
Und mama le Satan.
Are you listening to me say?
Dominion, brother.
Ubukhosi.
Dominion.
Ubukhosi.
She put the phone there.
Why kushe ke phone?
And then we dialed.
Siphone.
And brother Lubabalo got the phone.
Umsa Lubabalo wayifumana ke phone.
And the rest was history.
Yabe konke ke kuyimbali emveni koko.
After the phone.
Emveni kwe phone.
There was no more fighting.
Bekungekho ukuqambula.
There was a manifestation of what was discussed on the way. God manifested himself. Yeah, now if God can bring back a cell phone, he can bring back your son. He can bring back your daughter. He can bring back your husband. He can bring back your family member. Hallelujah. My God is able, brother. Whatever you ask from the Lord, he can give it to you. Hey, the devil likes to chance. When we leave, I service the vehicle. When we passed Kopas.
When we went past
Duckets. Yeah, my daughter. All of a sudden.
Just coupe of vagaling no motor in.
Yeah, my daughter. Yeah, let me all.
This noise.
Udo Satan akum chika.
And the devil says, turn around.
Did he copy it?
I said, what you say?
And
the devil says, turn around. In the car. It's quiet. Everyone is listening to the noise. They don't know I'm fighting a battle.
Did Satan mamela?
I'm saying, devil, listen here.
Yeah?
I am not going to turn around. I will show you something.
Younger brother, I pushed that car to 170.
My Lord.
I said, devil, I want to show you. I can go house speed with this noise. That car took us and come back. That's my God, brother. Don't you listen to the devil. God keeps his word, brother. Always keeps his word. Believers. If you don't fast and pray, you are living a defeated life. If you don't fast and pray, I'm telling you, you're going to be the most sick person. You come here,
you ask us to pray for your own sugar demon. It's yours. This sugar demon, you call for it for yourself. This high blood pressure, you call for yourself. Just fast. And ask and plead
I'm
the Lord.
I'm telling you, if you do that, brother, he's surely going to respond. Fasting and praying must become a norm. It's normal for me to fast for 2 days in a week as if nothing happened. And then the other day I was on a fasting. I was on a 2-day fast. And then I want to break the fast. And I told myself, I'm going to break the fast with I just want to eat a protein. And I went to this brown butchery. And I said, give me one piece of steak.
And A grade.
They say, hey, Pastor, do you really want to
pray?
It's full, yeah. I said, okay. They say, no, go next door. There's ready-made meat next door. When I got there, when I look at that ready-made meat, when I look, that I
could see it's already cold.
As I know, there's death in the pot here. I leave that when I go to the next butchery. And when I look, I ask him, hey, man, don't you have A-grade meat?
abanayo ke inyama eludidi luphezulu.
So what do you mean?
But ndithi kutheni?
Ndithi andifuni inkomo endala.
I don't want inyama the old
inyama yethole e soft.
I want ndifuna le thambi leyo.
Athi hayi asithengisi apha.
They say no, we don't sell that.
Ndithi Lord, thank you.
Nathi Nkosi bawo.
You are telling me I must continue with my fast.
Uyandicela uba mandiqhubeke ke ndizila Nkosi.
Out of that butchery,
yeah.
I went to the next shop
because
I was washing the car. I went to the next shop
and
there was a Hindu.
Okay.
And I told him, I didn't know he's a Hindu. I told him my experience. I said, you know what? I'm a believer. I'm on a fast. I wanted to break my fast today. I come from a two-day fast. And I explained to him what I said. Now the Lord actually tells me I must continue my fast. You know what this guy says? I say, yo, I'm a Hindu. We also fast. I said, we don't just fast. We fast and pray. You see, my conversation with that Hindu ended up to be more than an hour. More than an hour. And a Hindu told me that when he fasts, he doesn't just see results in his body. He sees results in his life. Now they don't worship a living God. We're worshiping a living God, brother. And if a Hindu can see a change in his body, we're going to have a body change. By the preaching of the word, we shall be changed.
The Lord.
Ooh, you love the Lord this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Who fast and pray this week? Who fast and pray this week? Don't be afraid, man, you're going to give away your clothes. Don't be afraid you're going to give away your clothes, man. God will provide something else. Amen. Fast and pray. Fast and pray.
Praise
the Lord. You know, I spoke to Rushka. I said, Rushka, join me in the fast today. She didn't know that was my second day. And she said, okay, pa. Hey, pa, Andia, it is our lamb.
I will get hungry, though.
Did Rushka just join me? Said, okay, can I start my fast 8:30? Okay, you can start 8:30. 8:30, Rushka phones me.
Why do you phone her? 8:30.
Pa.
What, Tata?
My fast has started.
Go, go, Zila. I
said, let's go, Rushka. Let's go.
Amen.
Hey, 12 o'clock.
What, 12 o'clock?
Rushka phoned me on a video call.
Where are you phone like a Rushka? The phone?
He said, hey, Tata.
Says, Dad.
Tila Benyan.
I am really hungry now.
Rushka, that's the time you must press through. You must press through. Hallelujah. She pressed through, and when she came home, she says, I made it. I made it. If you can overcome yourself, you can overcome any demon. If you can overcome yourself, you can overcome any demon, brother. Fasting is training you how to become an overcomer. Can I say it again? Fasting is training you how to become an overcomer. If you can overcome yourself, you can overcome any demon, brother.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. You appreciate the Lord. Now, when the Lord revealed to me that, I then realized why people can't forgive. I said, this one has never fasted. Because forgiveness, you have to overcome yourself first. This person has done you bad. Overcome yourself and forgive, brother. Amen. You appreciate the Lord this morning. Amen. Hallelujah.
We want to welcome our pastor Kivit's wife this morning.
Where
is she? Praise the Lord. God bless you, my sister. Welcome to the house of God this morning. Amen.
Amen.
No sister Nasiwe Tukela Sagamgela Pagatuke to sister. Sister Nasiwe. God bless you, my sister. Welcome. Sometimes she's part of what I'm guessing. Hallelujah. Now I'm now from Paramuti. Amen.
You are free to say amen and stand up and say blessed amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Brother Sibusiso, where is he?
Sibusiso.
God bless you, my brother. Welcome to the house of God. Amen. And Sister Sandiswa Majaza. Sister Sandiswa. Where is he? Amen. That side. Okay, God bless you, amen. God bless you. God bless you, the Sunday as well. Amen. Blessed be the name. We appreciate the testimonies, amen. We have our Pastor Floyd here with the Church of King Williamstown. Can we give them a hand of praise? Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And we appreciate Pastor Floyd and Sister Lynette.
Floyd. Amen. Your Sister Floyd.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Appreciate Brother Wellington here. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. And then we've got baptism that's going to happen next week. Amen. It's Sister Kwezi and Sister Buyiswa. Amen. Hallelujah. So, praise the Lord. Amen. So, baptism next week. Amen. Praise the Lord. The baptism pool is right at the back. That's where we will be baptizing. Amen. Upcoming events. There's a wedding coming up. What date is that wedding? Can you just put it up there? That wedding of our brother Jeremiah. Like the Afrikaans Jeremiah. It finds out like Jeremiah. Look there, she says to me, I don't know. They don't have it there, but it's supposed to be there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. What is the date? 26th of October.
26th of October.
Amen. We've got that wedding there. And then on the 6th of October,
October.
We are, the whole church is going to Queenstown. And then on our way back, we're going to attend evening service in
Stadtrijm.
Amen. So we ask people to indicate whether they're going. Thus far, there's more than 40 people going. But please, those that haven't put up their names, we'll give you time. Because towards the end of the month, we'll ask the deacon to come and ask you into Nagyaku.
What is your problem? Because we are all going.
We are Amba, Sister Moon.
Amba
song.
Song.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Brother Pumzile is a son of ours. And ever he has established the church there in Queenstown, we never went to show him respect.
So
on that Sunday, we are going to Queenstown. And coming back, we're going to attend service in Stadtrijm. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to call a fast. We will tell you when to call the. We're going to call the fast. It's going to be a 3-day fast. And we will be claiming Noah's healing. Brother Ivan's grandson. We are claiming the healing that God already performed at
Calvary. There is no way that you continue to have your life usual when the devil is tormenting other people. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're going to claim it and tell the devil what God did to General Zechariah, he will do to Noah. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. We've got a church AGM this Saturday at
3:00.
So all of you are invited. We just have to revisit our year plan and finalize. I think there's two more issues that we need to finalize for this year. It's the day for the elderly, and then also the year end family day. Amen. So coming from next week, I think the treasurer will come and announce how much the taxi will be to go to Queenstown and back. So on the 6th of October, nobody must be in a hurry. After the morning service, we want him to leave.
And then
we go to start time. God bless you. We celebrate this morning. You know, when you're at work, you must know you are a believer. You must be better than other people. So this morning, we celebrate one of our own, Sister Mahlohlo, Sister Sinazo.
Okay.
Hey, I forgot the brothers put up this thing.
Sister Sinazo,
she has been declared the best supervisor in that government department. That's my God. Can we give them this a hand of praise? Hallelujah. Amen. No, you sit there.
Or you speak to yourself.
You're
looking there. You're speaking closer. Where do we come into this one? We are in it already.
Because the Bible says you must, whatever you do, you must do as you do it unto the Lord. Whatever you do, you must do it as you do it unto the Lord. So when I'm the babus basing and happy,
if you're asking, Duke Fatile can go
up, we are corner, O young Napo.
You are part of the issue.
Tanunga Tant.
Like it or
that's
not
a manifestation of the word. You appreciate the Lord this morning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to welcome God's servant. So welcome God's servant to come and preach the unsearchable riches of Christ.
Wanguwe
to the pala la chenga hamanzi hoka tati ekele wanguwe to the pala la chenga hoka tati ekele.
Sister Venetia, where the homegoing of her aunt. Hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord. You won't see me comment when people go on the WhatsApp group. I can't do two things. I'm an expectation for the raising of the dead. I will not announce death. The deacon will announce it, but me, I'm looking forward for resurrection.
Just bow heads for
one, two.
Pray.
Amen.
Praise God. Father, we come before your throne of grace this morning.
Amen.
Your throne of grace and mercy. Hallelujah. Oh God, before the foundation of the world, Lord, it was an eternal throne. Almighty God and Father, Lord God, there was no need to call it a throne of grace, because nobody has fallen, Lord God. But this morning, Father, we come here before thine throne, Father. Abraham Branham said, Almighty God, when we come before that throne, Almighty God, we come before it, Father, knowing who we are, Lord, and knowing who we approach,
yes,
Lord. Oh God, and the Bible says it's impossible to please you without faith this morning.
Amen.
This morning is our prayer that you will anoint our faith. Lord, give us a faith this morning, Almighty God, to get a grip on that infallible promise of the Almighty God. Father, Almighty God, so that we can live a life, Almighty God, Father, that it become a threat, Lord God, to the kingdom of Satan. Bless us this morning. If there's any sick, Lord, and feeble among us this morning, needy, Lord God, shackled and chained, Lord God, I pray this morning, Almighty God, may the power of God this morning, Father, Lord God, flood through this place this
yes.
morning. May grace flood through this place this morning.
Jesus,
may the promises of God flood through this place this morning, Lord God, and rest, Father, resting place upon the hearts of your people, Lord God, this morning, Father, so that we can leave this place, Almighty God, Lord God, more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Bless us this morning, Father, Lord, as we are gathering here, Lord, each and every one of us from different households, Lord, and different needs this morning. But this morning, Father, there's only one center need, Almighty God, and that is more of thee, O God. Father, the more Christ we have, Lord God, Father, everything else will fall in place. And that's why this morning we pray that we'll meet with us, Lord, be with the preaching of the word, Lord, the reading of the word, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, is my prayer this morning, Father, as the word is going to go forth, Lord God, may connect, Father, to, with that faith that is within that heart of the people this morning, Lord God, and may bring forth a miraculous, Lord God, a divine promise of the Almighty God. May this morning, Father, may we have a blessing in love divine, in Jesus Christ's name. Bless, Lord God, our precious brother, Lord, who's going to assist this morning with the interpretation this morning. I believe he's already anointed this morning. It's our prayer this morning, Father. May the fire of the Almighty God this morning, Father, Lord God, override, Father, anything, Almighty God, that the devil has tried, Almighty God, to interrupt the servant of the Almighty God. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen and amen. Give the man a praise this morning. We are grateful and blessed to be back in the house of our Lord Jesus this morning. Firstly, praise the Lord. Let us go to the word of the Almighty God first.
Amen.
And we can see where we are heading from there. Luke chapter 22.
Lukang
22. Verse 31 and 32. Very simple message this morning. A word of encouragement unto the people. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Luke 22.
Luke 21. Praise the Lord. Luke 22 from verse 31 and 32. Let us read. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan had desired to have you, that he might sift you as wheat.
He take a ingosi, Simon, Simon, uyabona, usatana ebenibanga, ukuba anele, njengengqolowa.
But I have prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. Father, we can close the Bible and we can simultaneously close the service.
Gracious Lord.
But I believe, Almighty God, there is maybe something that you need to share with your people this morning. So we pray that the anointing, the sweetness of the presence, the anointing of your being,
yes, Lord,
this morning, Almighty God, bring a peace that passes all understanding. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You may be seated. Praise God. The devil almost got me this morning. Praise God. Sometimes the devil tried to knock your emotions. But I believe a simple prayer of faith override that emotions. So this morning, firstly, I studied this message with a very, very heavy heart. It's one of those difficult times to study. But as I said, a simple prayer this morning brings a peace that passes all understanding. So firstly, we want to thank the Lord. allowing us to be here this morning. Under the echo of the word. Give a man a praise. Give a man a praise. Praise the Lord. Amen. And then I want to thank our precious Pastor Tony. Praise the Lord. I know Pastor Tony since 1989. And we, ever since, praise the Lord. I believe there was one message many, many years back. I
think
early 90s. When he wanted to preach a message, that is not a flowery bed of ease. He couldn't preach it. And I cannot recall any time where he came back and preached it. But God allowed it for us to experience the message without listening to it. So this morning, Pastor, I can say amen to that message that you preached. In fact, that you were about to preach. But character preached it through me. Praise the Lord. So I appreciate the invite, and I appreciate to my dear pastor, Sister Lynette, the family, and the church. May God richly bless you this morning.
Praise God.
Amen.
Man.
I also want to thank my wife. You know, usually see all these things, what these people, ministers were doing. Praise the Lord. And now we are also doing it. Now you feel so big and great now. To making all these comments and thank you this and this. Yeah, but so this morning I want to thank also my precious wife. Lynette. And also my children. Praise the Lord, also the church, amen. The brothers, the saints that came with me. Let me get back to the saints that came with me. Ne? Let me just say this, an apology. The saints who couldn't be here. Brother
Christo.
Also Brother Dion. And there's a lot of other believers who wanted to be here. So may God bless you. May God bless them as well. You know, sometimes you do so much for, you know, to contribute, you know, and be a blessing within the work of the Almighty God. But Wellington went to fetch the saints there in Kalash. But by the way, praise the Lord, I'm so happy to have them here this morning.
Amen,
praise the Lord. They are fresh with us. But they feel as if we've been for a long time. Amen, Sister Butisiwe, Mam Sauli, and also Mam Sweetie. Praise the Lord, it's really wonderful to have them here. But I want to come to this, you know. But Benham says in a message, without money, without price. He says we are living in a time where nobody wants to do anything for free anymore. In other words, what you are doing, you need payment in return. And but sometimes you can really see when people is doing things from their heart. I was, Brother Wellington was giving me the contributions of the money of the saints this morning. And I said, no, here's your share.
That can answer.
He says, no, Pastor, it's fine, leave it.
What is here?
So praise the Lord. And I looked at him, I thought by myself, yo. You know, these cars we are driving, it's driving on petrol, maintenance, etc. And here you still get people who says, no, I don't want anything in return. So may God bless you, my brother, man. For your labors of love.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. There's also one quote where Brother Branham says, hey, I'm a big talker when it comes, you know, but anyhow.
And the gumdu ke onenchayelo le ende kodwa ke akunani.
Brother Branham, you know, I take everything sometimes, you know, even if Brother Branham just make a comment, I take it as a quote, my brother.
Aw Brother Branham ke ecaphula into ka 13 into nje ngelithathi bese sicajula lonto.
He says, I won't be long, I will try not to be long.
Uthi andizuba mde ndizawuzama ndingabi mde.
Because there are people that must go to work. And there's people that must still travel. So I will take that quote this morning and say I tried not to be long. There's people like Brother Emo and they must still go back to PE today.
And
decide to be there a certain time. So may God bless our precious brother as well. Praise God, amen. Let us go. This morning, I believe I've covered everything. This morning, just for a few minutes, I'd like to speak on strengthened unto rapturing grace.
Womelezeke ukuya kubabalo lokuba mawuqhwilwe.
Strengthened unto rapturing grace. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus said to Peter,
Uyesu tuku Petrose,
after you are converted, go and strengthen your brethren. Let us read that scripture just for a while, just for a recap here quickly. Praise God. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Luke 22. You love the Lord this morning? Luke 22,
verse
31.
Luke
22, 31. And the Lord said, the headship of the Godhead. Praise God, amen. Simon. Simon.
Simon, Simon, Simon.
Now when your name is called twice, he wants to lay emphasis on this thing. He wants to lay the weight of what I'm about to tell you now. He wants you to remember this. You're going to need this. He said, Simon, Simon.
Simon, Simon.
Satan had desired to have you. He wanted you. That he may sift you as wheat. Verse
32.
But I have prayed for thee, for thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. If there is one thing that the devil is afraid of, is the blood of Jesus. The devil is afraid of that blood. Because there's something in that blood that he recognized. There's a voice in that blood. And he knows the voice in that blood is the voice that kicked him out of heaven. The same voice in that blood is the voice that spoke when he says, praise the Lord, when he spoke to Cain. You see the voice in that blood.
It's
so powerful. It is even active after death. So it doesn't matter. Even if you die today, the voice in that blood, it will still echo. It will still echo. The devil recognized that voice. When Jesus came to the man of
Gadara,
he recognized the same voice. When Jesus was in
Gethsemane,
he recognized the same voice. So the devil hates that blood. So who is that blood today? You, the church. The mystical body. Is that blood? By the spirit. So where is the voice? In that mystical body. So when you walk, the devil recognized. People see a white man, colored looking like a white guy. But the devil see the voice. So this morning, you can lift somebody up with a voice that's inside of you.
Oh yes, Lord.
Brother Branham says, I've read this quote
a
couple of weeks back, maybe 2 months back. So,
Branham
says, God keeps his word. Aren't you glad for that? Praise God.
Man.
God keeps his word. You see, when Elijah spoke to that Shumanite woman, and he says the oil,
what the oil
will not run dry. The flour, what do you call?
Nomkubo
will not finish. So where is that oil today? Where is that flour today? It's gone. Because after the drought, everything went back to normal. But the word
God
that spoke that, the word that spoke it unto that Shumanite woman, that word is still active. When Jesus spoke and to the fish and the bread, and he was praying, where is that fish and bread today? It's gone. By the word that spoke it, it's in our midst now. So the word must come a reality to you. Unless the word becomes the reality, you will not get strengthened. You will stay weak, lukewarm and backslidden. But as long as that word, as long as that word, until that word becomes the reality, it will strengthen you. Brother says, and brother, sister, I've read this few months back, and I don't know why. I prepared a few notes, but I didn't speak on it. Brother says, and brother, sister, I know the trials are hard. I'm getting old.
Cool.
And I've preached.
Shumayele.
I've done everything that I know
Denze
to do.
Kona, go in Magwenze.
I've got to a place
kumango
to where I see I can't do no more.
Upon bon bak sekondo no yenza kwa kona.
You know what? This
has been spoken 1957. 8 years. Before Brother Branham left the earth. And here Brother Branham says that I've got to a place to where I can see I can't do no more. He still had 8 years to go. He was in his second pool. He was not even in the third pool ministry yet. And Brother Branham thought that it was finished. He was done. Can you see to what state the devil can bring you? He can bring you to a state where you think I am finished. I am done. But there's still many more years for you to come. The devil tried to blind you to your purpose. He weakens you. He says, I've just laid the whole thing in the lap of the Lord Jesus. I'm riding on it. I'm riding on God's promise. Praise God, amen.
Amen.
Right here, Brother
Branham
is about to enter into his latter ministry. Brother Branham is citing his Omega chapter of his life. But they have no idea the challenges that lays ahead. What made him? What kept him 8 years more? It's because he put everything in the lap of Jesus. I said it's going to be a simple message. Come on. So this morning, unless you want to dry yourself out and exhaust yourself and frustrate yourself, you can take everything and try to handle it. That morning, put it in the lap of Jesus. Ride in the promises of God. And you will continue until the end, brother.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
You see, when Jesus came to Gethsemane,
I figure Gethsemane, yes.
He came to the latter part of his ministry. He came to the omega of his ministry. And here Jesus, the cross is right here. Jesus saw everything that's about to take place. He knew every thorn on that crown. Jesus knew exactly how many inches or millimeters that thorn will be crushed in his skull. Jesus knew the very distance, the speed of that whip. He knew how many steps on the way to Calvary, on to Golgotha. I mean, on his way to
Golgotha.
Jesus knew exactly where he's going to fall. He says, Lord, let this cup pass me. I cannot take it. You said you can never put something upon me that I cannot handle. So I'm asking you now to take it away. Is there no plan B, G, but God? Father, is there no plan B? There is no plan B. As long as you stay in the will of God, God, the will of God will take you to the end. Throw yourself in the will of God, and then His will will take you to purpose. But not my will. Let thy will be done. What strengthened Jesus? We're getting there. You see, a person who is strengthened is resting in the Holy Ghost. A person that is strengthened is resting in the Holy Ghost. So if you want to be strengthened this morning, get in the Holy Ghost. Get in the Holy Ghost. Praise God.
Amen.
The more strengthened you become, the more incompetent you become. The more you realize, I cannot do this. How can I do this? I am incompetent.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
You don't want to make anything, any place, any step without Him.
Oh, yes, Lord. Amen. Glory to God.
I've always said many times, how many of us made very stupid mistakes in our lives? Listen. You are filled with the Holy Ghost. You love the Lord. Oh my, you're looking forward for the coming of the Lord. But yet you make stupid mistakes. I always say compassion is infallible. Praise God. Brenham says, he says, I, the Lord, hath planted it. I water it. Listen to the vocabulary of the prophet. I, the Lord, hath planted it, past tense. When did he plant it? Today? When you accept Him? No. He planted it before. Before your mother knew even her mother. Praise God.
Man.
Hallelujah. So he says the Lord hath planted it. Listen to the next word. I water it. Not watered. So it's not only a present tense thing, but it's a perpetual, sorry bro, it's a continuous thing. Day and night. Lest some should pluck it from my hand. While you are sleeping, Brother Christo, You know nothing about yourself. God is protecting his promise in your heart. When you want to go out to the world and become lukewarm, God is protecting his promise in your heart. He is watering it while you are sleeping. Why do you think when you get up in the morning there's a joy in your heart? He was watering the promise in your heart while you were sleeping.
Hallelujah.
God's church will endure forever. Brother Branham says so. You know, I love the word. And I like to dig, man. That word endure. You go to the lexicons. You go to the Weymouth. You go to the Arabic translation. That word endure, it means to endure temptation. Not trials. Not difficulties. Not sorrow and pain. You see, even the sadness outside can endure difficulties. A person without Christ, without the Holy Ghost, without the revelation of the message, can endure difficulties and trials, pain and sorrow. We are no different than them. But give them temptation. It's only the bride that can withstand temptation in this hour because of the revealed word. Brother Branham says that the seven thunders is your tribulation. So there's your strengthening unto the change, unto the body change. Brother Branham says the church will endure forever. And we know Brother Branham says that forever has got a window period. Forever has got expiry date. Even forever will come to an end. So here Brother Branham says that God will, God's church will endure forever. In other words, you will endure temptation until the end. Because you, there's no temptation beyond time. There's no temptation beyond time. So you endure temptation forever. When that forever ends with you, mortality and immortality. Time blending to eternity. Praise God.
Amen.
Precious Lord.
Amen.
You see, God's church in the past, churches were packed. Today, people in the message,
it's
so worldly.
Yet
they are in church. And the
sun
is scattered into the world. And then when we look at all these things that is happening, if you do not blame the ministers, we blame the church.
If you don't blame the church, you blame the individuals. But you see, it's the season and the time that we are living in. You see, you cannot strengthen unbelievers. Jesus said to Peter, go and strengthen your brethren. You cannot go and strengthen an unbeliever. Go and find out the word brethren. It means believer. You cannot go and strengthen an unbeliever. You need to warn them and then they need to be converted. After they are converted, they can be strengthened.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
So it's a believer that is already in the faith. So after you are converted, go and strengthen your brothers.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
So how can you go and strengthen someone without the Holy Ghost? You need the Holy Ghost. After you are converted, then you are in the position, in an authorization, to go and strengthen without the Holy Ghost. Wait until you are converted. Because you're going to do more damage than good.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Strengthened.
Yomeleza.
2 Peter 1, verse 10 and 13. The Bible says, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. And I got that from a margin of the Bible. Brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if he do these things, he shall never fail. He shall never fail. There is no way that compassion can fail. Compassion cannot fail. It is you and I who fail. So there is a correlation between Luke 22:32 and 2 Peter 1.
No. Petros and Lois Bini.
Verse 13. Yea, I think it meet. As long as I am in this tabernacle. This tabernacle. To stir you up by putting you in remembrance. So there is your strengthener. There is the one who is doing the strengthening. The fivefold ministry. The Holy Ghost is your strengthener. Praise God, amen.
Amen.
So that is clear. That is not the man that is edifying. It is not the man that is strengthening. It is the Holy Ghost. So when you strengthen someone, and that person gains strength, and you feel proud, was it really you? There's a big problem. Praise God.
Yes, oh yes.
It is the Holy Ghost of fivefold ministry. The mystical part of the Ephesians 4 ministry that comes behind the pulpit and release the inspiration. And when they release the inspiration, you are strengthened. Those that are not converted are converted.
Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen.
So you are making your calling and election sure. We'll try to dwell on the notes so that I'm not long. Amen. You are making your calling and election sure by submitting to the Spirit of Truth. When you submit to the Spirit of Truth, you are being strengthened unto your body change. Praise God. So the submission to the Spirit of Truth strengthens you unto a rapturing faith for rapturing grace. Praise God.
Merciful Lord.
After you are converted, so it's now the Holy Ghost doing the work, doing the speaking, the strengthening. That is what we need more. We need more Holy Ghost in the church. The more Holy Ghost in the church, the stronger the church, the more stable the church, the less world in the church, the less lukewarmness, the more fire. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
Praise the Lord.
So you are strengthened by the voice of your day. So how can you gain strength if you don't listen to the prophet? You need to listen to the prophet. Get under the anointing of your day. So you are strengthened by the voice of your day, bringing you back to the original worship. And what is the original worship? Spirit and truth. Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. So the anointing of his being through the sanctifying grace of the blood is bringing you back to God. Can I say that again? The anointing of his being, which is his deity, through the sanctifying grace of the blood, bringing you back to God. Therefore, the mystical body is now anointed with the same logos. You are anointed this morning with the same logos. The logos that was before the world began. The logos that led the children of Israel. The logos. 1951. At a debate of the Godhead. When Brother Branham refused to go. And Brother Bosworth fallen said he wants to go. And then Brother Branham slipped in. Because he didn't like debates. And when they ask him to open or close the debate,
but
fire appeared. What was that? The logos. So where is that logos today?
Upike lomkulu namhlanje welizwi.
You are anointed with the same logos.
Praise
God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, let me not go into that now. Oh my goodness.
Praise the Lord.
Philippians 2:8.
What's up, Philip?
We're not going to read it.
As if wonder.
Praise the Lord. You can, if you have something to write down, the scriptures, you do that.
When Zalondo is born,
just to save some time. So we're just going to mention the scriptures. Amen. For the sake of time. In Philippians 2:8, it is you that the Lord, in his being, is found in fashion. That's what fashion means, in appearance. As a man. And signifies what he was in the eyes of men. So the entirely outwardly perceptible mode and shape of his existence, how we perceive him through his visible form in our midst. The Bible says in Philippians 2, verse 8, that he fashioned himself as a man. Not of a man. Of a man means you come from that
man.
But as a man, morphed. He morphed himself as a man.
Hallelujah.
So in other words, absolutely everything conspires so that this person, Christ, was actually a man to men. That is what he always desired. So he's a man to men, strengthening men. You expect an angel with wings in the kitchen. You expect a light in your room. He fashioned himself as a man to strengthen you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord.
So here the being of God, deity. I don't know if I mentioned it here. I mentioned it many times. That the revelation of the Godhead comes out of the revelation of the deity. You cannot have a revelation of the Godhead without the revelation of the deity. The revelation of deity induced the revelation of the Godhead. Give man a praise.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord.
Brenham says, okay, let me just say this quickly. So here is the being of God, the deity, is strengthening you through someone that eats like you, that drinks water like you, that live among you, that go and sleep and is tired like you. The deity of God is strengthening you through someone
that make mistakes like you.
Owenza impazamo njengawe.
Brother Branham says, and I just wonder if that ain't the attitude of a many cool, good, true-hearted preacher today. That's long to see a church built without spot or wrinkle. I have many desires for our local church. Many.
Minins minweno.
But I'm telling you,
you
can put all of them together. It will not even come close to my main core desire. Is to see Christ in them.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
To see the promises of God made manifest.
Brother
Branham says we've tussled and tried, the ministers, and screamed and cried. You can put parents in there. And preach till we was hoarse. And laid on our pillows and wept. Oh God,
oh Tiko,
why is it just when we get straightened up? I said I read this quote a few months back and I put it here. Just when we get straightened up, that in comes the devil and bust up and tears up and just knocks down everything we got. We can do when we see our lovely, what can we do when we see our lovely people? How they be scattered and gone about like that. So you preach to the people. You people go out and go and live like the world again. You preach. You go out and you see that the family life does not get better. That's it what Brother Branham is talking about here. So he's preaching in vain. God already prayed for you because your faith is anointed to the unfailing realities of God that strengthens you unto rapturing grace. You are sifted. You know most when you sift something, what you want must go through the safe.
Yeah.
What you don't want must remain. Now, have you ever seen someone sifting something? And after you sift this thing, whether it's flour or what?
Nobody flour when you don't know.
And after you sift, you take the stuff that is in the sift and you mix it with other things that has already been sifted. It means we are cuckoo. You are not right here.
Hallelujah.
What is the purpose of sifting? So this morning, you are sifted. What remains on top? We are not interested. Going to the rubbish bin. You are in the bucket.
When I get with baguette,
about to be mixed with the divine promise of God to bring forth Christ unto rapturing grace.
Ukuya kubabalo kwilo.
Sift means an act of sifting something.
Ukusefa ke yinto yokuba usefa into ithile.
Especially so as so isolate that which is most important.
Ukwenzela uba wahlule le nto ibalulekileyo.
So why do we complaining about the sifting?
Kutheni ke sikhalazela ukusefwa?
Lord, why do you sift me like this?
Kutheni Nkosi undela ngolu hlobo?
He wants to use you.
Ufuna ukusebenzisa. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
So until only word is left in you, nothing else, he's
going
to keep on sifting you.
God
will keep on sifting you. He's
going
to sift you until there's no you left anymore. All he can see is words. And then the rapture goes.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Now, the bride has got to learn to stand with what she believes. What she understands. In other words, the mystical part, having preeminence over the fallen creation, which is the flesh, the mind, and the. So the mystical part having preeminence over the fallen creation. So the maturity of your understanding will steer how you deal with temptation. So the way you deal with temptation reflects your maturity of your spiritual understanding. Up to where you have been strengthened.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
My boy goes.
So the work in the bride, the work in her, the endurance unto temptation, moved from its written, do not my will. Do you hear what I'm saying? The maturity, the endurance of temptation have moved from it is written to not my will, Lord. What happened to not my way in the position of not my will? Is the unveiling of character. Because Romans 5 verse 3, 4.
Roma 5, 3, 4.
He says that patience
uti umonde
worketh experience which is character.
Usebenza amava ekusisimo.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Bayibonga Nkosi.
You see at the River Jordan.
Yabona emlanjeni Jordan.
After Jesus came from the River Jordan.
Emveni buYesu esiphuma emlanjeni Jordan.
Where he has received
or
reflected the acceptance of the acceptance of the Holy Ghost, of to receive the Holy Ghost. He went from Jordan, and when the Bible says the Spirit led him into the wilderness. Yes, he didn't go into the wilderness because he wanted to hunt. He didn't go into the wilderness trying to relax. The Spirit sent him into the wilderness.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
So when he came into the wilderness, and then the temptation came, there was no praying in the wilderness. He used it is written. You see, temptation was still in its infancy. Smoking, drinking,
gossip,
politics, adultery, stay away from church, all these things. It was still in the infancy. You do things and you don't do things because the Bible says you must not do. You do it because it is the right thing to do. But you see, when he came in the Garden of Gethsemane, that's now when patience worked at character. I said I'm
going
to get to it. How he was strengthened. When he came in the Garden of
Gethsemane,
there was no "it is written." Why didn't Jesus told the same devil that met him, I don't know how many, about 3 years back, the same devil, about 3 years back, because Brother Branham says his ministry lasted about 3 years.
Praise the Lord.
Why didn't he say to the same devil, "It is written"? He couldn't. The temptation was at another level. There was no time to "it is written" here. You see, when you're out there and your friends want to let you do something wrong, you can tell them, "I cannot do this thing. I cannot go there. I should do it this way." But you see, when he came there, he didn't have the strength. What made him not to say "it is written"? The Bible says that he prayed so fervently that even the blood, that the sweat turning to blood, that was the agony, the pain that he endured.
Praise the Lord.
So yeah, he prayed, and he came to the disciples, and they were sleeping, and he says, "Why are you sleeping? You need to pray without ceasing." Praise God.
Amen.
You see, we want it vice versa. I'm guiding you how you're going to get strengthened this morning. Maybe 5 minutes and we close here.
Yeah.
We want it vice versa in the message today. When we are young in the faith, we are praying without ceasing. Our prayer life is there. And as the years goes on, the prayer life drops, and we become more "it is written." We want "it is written" after 20 years in the message. That is not the time. It is time to pray without ceasing. Because the level of temptation now is much higher. The devil is about to destroy you now.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
You see, later we want to speak the word. But our prayer life is starving. We want to go around and speak the word. But your prayer life is starving.
Hallelujah.
You see, on the cross, they wanted him to speak the word. If you say who you say you are, why don't you speak and deliver yourself and us? But you see, Jesus knew that was no time to speak the word when you are fulfilling purpose. You see, the word has ripened unto purpose. Right now we are living in the season. We are living in the time where the word, the revealed word, has unfolded and has been ripened unto purpose. Now purpose is gonna usher you in into the third exodus, which is the changing of the body.
Praise the Lord.
There was no it written in the Garden of Eden as understanding and character has ripened unto the husbandman. I'm going to close now.
So far.
You see, Matthew 4, verse 4, Luke 4, verse 4.
Luke 4, verse 4.
Induced. Or bring about cause to what happened.
Matthew
26:39.
Matthew 4:4.
You shall not live by bread alone. Lead to or induced. Matthew 26:39. Not my will, Lord. But let your will be done. Matthew 3:16-17.
Unfolded.
Or induced. Matthew 4:4. What does Matthew 3:16-17
says?
This is my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased.
And you call his way on Guya.
It stopped right there. So Matthew 3:16-17. Lead him. Or strengthen him. Until Matthew 4:4.
Hallelujah.
Where he says,
Apo Ati.
Where was Matthew 3:16? Just for clarity.
Matthew 3:16-17.
Robert Jordan, right? When he was baptized. Let me be fair this morning. So Matthew 3:16-17 occurred when Jesus was at the river Jordan, when the dove came down. Old timers, just be patient, amen. When the dove came down, and he says, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. That is Matthew 3:16. So Matthew 3:16-17. That what happened there when the dove came down. The dove strengthened him. For Matthew 4:4. When he was in the wilderness. And when he was tempted. You see, he needed Matthew 3:16. without Matthew 3:16, he would never be able to have the strength to withstand temptation in Matthew 4:4, where you could utter the word it is written. So before we can use the word it is written, you need to have a Matthew 3:16-17 experience. Otherwise the devil's gonna hey yo
umtholi wakujuda.
And then Matthew 4:4. Induced or strengthened him unto Matthew 17:5. The cloud, the judge, Mount Transfiguration. There cannot be a Matthew 17:5 without the Matthew 3:16. And there cannot be a Matthew 4:4 without Matthew 3:16. So Matthew 4:4, when he had the strength to say it is written, it strengthened him unto Matthew 17:5. He was so full of strength that his body was changed from mortality to immortality, which signifies the rapture. And Matthew 17:5. Strengthen him unto
Matthew 26:39. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Let us Matthew 26:39 says.
Can
we read it? Let us read it. We're closing now. Okay, praise the Lord. Hey, wonderful. Matthew 26:39. And he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt. I wanted to read it. So now you understand that Matthew 17:5 strengthened him unto Matthew 26:39. Without Matthew 17:5, those three words, yea, him, strengthened him unto Matthew 26. Not my will, Lord. There's no will left in you no more. The only will that will remain is the perfect will. That is how you're going to be strengthened. So God is going to take you from Matthew 3:16 to Matthew 4:4, from Matthew 4:4 to Matthew 17:5, from Matthew 17:5, he's going to take you to your purpose. Matthew 26:39, you will and you are strengthened unto a greater faith for rapturing grace. God bless you.
Hallelujah. You appreciate the word this morning. You appreciate the word this morning. Bless you, be the name of the Lord. Turn to your neighbor.
khawuguquka kummelwanecela ummelwana ndisenkonzweni ekuseni.
Tell your neighbor,
hallelujah,
I have been in church this morning. Oh, praise God, praise God. You appreciate Pastor Floyd this morning. You may be seated just for a while. Hallelujah. Oh, what a word. What a word.
Thank you, Lord.
Now let's bring it to the present tense. Luke 22. Verse 31. And the Lord said, yesterday, Dudley, behold,
Kangela,
Satan had desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you.
Ooh,
listen, Pastor Floyd.
I don't know what I
would have said. You get my point? I mean, God doesn't say, I have asked the devil to leave you alone. He says, no, I'm not going to ask for that. What I'm going to ask, I'm going to ask that your faith fail thee not. Jesus could not change in the Garden of Gethsemane. He could not change, brother, because he had the revelation that I have come down to lay down my life and pick it up again. It has been revealed to him. Hallelujah. You appreciate the Lord this morning.
Says, I don't get any rest from the enemy. Problems on all sides. God uses Satan. Go and sieve Mona. Mona, she's full of herself. I want to take it out, Satan, but I want you to go and take it out.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The thing I don't want from Mona, I want you to go and take it out. I did not put it in there. You put it in there.
And the Lord sent the devil to sift you.
I'm too melty to control away.
That thing that he doesn't like,
landwanga ifuniyo,
remains.
Ihlalanga phezulu.
And is thrown to the rubbish bin.
Ilahlwe emgomeni.
What does God do?
Wenzani uThixo?
You use Satan as a slave.
Usebenzisa umtyholi njenge
khoboka. To bring you to perfection.
Akuzise kugqibelelo.
You use Satan as a slave. To bring you to perfection. God bless you, Pastor Floyd. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When thou art converted, strengthen your brethren.
Yomeleza abazalwane bakho.
So ukuba usekhona wabukhubekisa abazalwane.
If you make brethren to stumble,
ubachafisa.
You make them weary on the road.
It is bhalo akuguquka.
The Bible says you are not converted.
Itsho atsho ndim.
It's not me, it's the Bible.
Hallelujah. It but I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not.
Okokuba ukholo lwakho lungasileli.
And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. Hallelujah. So now we are
if you make people stumble, there is
a definite problem. It's not me, but the word declares it. You are not converted. If you are not converted, God will call the enemy. Say, Satan, come here. Come here and sieve him, Satan. What is he removing? Devil, you put that issue. You take it out. Pastor, come and pray over me, please. For me. And he causes the pastor to have another problem so that he cannot come to you. God does not want to be disturbed when he's busy saving you out.
Then the pastor is going to come and pray, Lord, take away the problem.
Pastor will come as God will tell the pastor, it's me, wait.
Praise the Lord. You appreciate the Lord this morning. Amen. You appreciate Pastor Floyd this morning. What a word. We all have been served this morning. We have been served by the word. We have been served by the word. And there's only one thing that remains. We have no will of our own. We have the will of God. Father, not my will, but let thy will be done. When I become incompetent, then God takes over. Lord, I can do no more. I'm incompetent. He takes over. You appreciate the Lord this morning. Amen. Let's stand to our feet this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's have a wonderful song. Amen. Let's sing that song.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Zethu Nkosi phambi kwetrone yakho engcwele siyakhwaza Nkosi siyakhwaza kumkani phambi kwalo trone yakho suthi uyingcwele wena uyingcwele uyingcwele Yehova wemikhosi udumo lonke Nkosi likufanele ngalentsasa namhlanje kumkani asimbonanga ngomnye ethi masimdumise Nkosi Asimbonanga ngomnye ofana nawe Moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke kubo bonke othixo Moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke Sibonile Nkosi ukuthi kufanelekile Nkosi Moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke ukuthi sisondele Nkosi kwiqrone yeqrone zakho Moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke siyabulela kumkani ngoba Nkosi akuthanda ngathina Nkosi uba sibekule ndawo uyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke koko wena Nkosi nguwe Nkosi othe wasitsala Nkosi ungaphakathi kwethu wasitsala Nkosi usitsalele elizweni lakho moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke zikhona izinto Nkosi sininzi Nkosi sikhazimla moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke kodwa wena Nkosi wasitsalela kweyona ndawo Nkosi idelelekileyo emehlweni abantu moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke indawo Nkosi yokuphumla ebantwaneni bakho moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke siyabulela kumkani ngomkhonzi wakho Nkosi uPastor Floyd kumkani othe wamsebenzisa Nkosi kule ndawo moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke wamnika amandla wamnika amandla ongezeliweyo kumkani ukuthi athethe ngelizwi lakho moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke siyakubulela kumkani kumkani Thixo namandla wonke ngoba Nkosi ilizwi lakho Nkosi lifana neqele moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke lihlabalahlule kumkani moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke nangoku moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke usathana umile ulindile ngapha kwala masango Nkosi efuna ukusenya moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke siyakubulela kumkani ngoba Nkosi ukhuphe Nkosi iintshikelosi zakho Nkosi sathandaza ngathi sakhunga ngathi moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke siyakubulela ke kumkani egameni lenkosi ethe nguYesu Kristu nalibandla lakho Nkosi moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke khakhulusikelele kumkani ulommeleze entweni zonke egameni lenkosi ethe nguYesu Kristu siyathandaza nangomlungiseleli webandla abazalwana iidikhonzi moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke oodade bethu moyingcwele Thixo namandla wonke abasisikelelana ngemihlabelelo kule ndawo siyathandaza ke kumkani egameni lenkosi ethe nguYesu Kristu amen
And you may be seated. We appreciate the word this morning. Blessed be the. You can do better than that. Do you appreciate the word this morning?
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. God bless you. We have service on Thursday evening. Praise the name of the Lord on Saturday. We've got our church meeting at 3:00. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm standing here in front whilst the brother was praying. And I decided just to open my eyes. And I looked to the door. And all the brothers at the door's eyes were closed. It's not supposed to be like that. The door, your eyes must be open.
It's bad outside.
I've read in the newspaper yesterday that these criminals, they went to a school there in PE and they robbed
they robbed the teachers. And the children were just screaming because they just saw guns. Okay, we have read how they rob churches. Now we're also reading how they rob schools. Yeah, a deacon is a policeman. We must keep our eyes open. Hallelujah, because we are not all believers. Sometimes you'll see people come to the church, he's an unbeliever. And whilst we are praying, he will steal somebody's cell phone. Because he's not a believer. So we have to be watching, pray. Otherwise, Satan will infiltrate us. You appreciate the Lord? Amen. So we need deacons here also to guard that door. And that door. And when the minister comes in, the deacons must go around and make sure that door is locked. Right? We don't want people to get hurt here. And you would say, no, Pastor, it's reality.
Living in this day.
When the minister comes in, somebody must go and check whether that door is locked. Keep the doors guarded. And even at your house, Sister Tandi, when you're alone there, lock the gate. Lock the gate. Days are cruel. May God richly bless you.
Till
we meet again. Shalom, Pastor.
Yeah.
Brother Wellington. He's just in his own league. Praise the name of the Lord. Until we meet again on Thursday. Amen. Sister Sweetie, I heard Sister Sweetie from Kalashle. Sister Sweetie. God bless you, Makoko. Hallelujah.
Might have come in here being bitter.
They are not
leaving bitter because Sweetie was here.
Go, Simam Sweetie.
Amen.
Praise the name. Banomye was at Kawakalash. God bless the Sebusisiwe. Banomye. Ban Mama was at Kalash. Mamkolo, amen. Hallelujah. Did I turn the Kalash?
I like Kalash.
Bendi hamba phanga ngenyawo ndingafakanga nehlanga bezinyawini.
I used to walk barefooted in Kalash.
Kunzima.
It was difficult those years.
Ngiyavuya nqandi vananga amakholo baphuma kula Kalash.
I am so encouraged when I hear there's believers coming from Kalash.
Yeah, they are inhliziyami imhlophe.
My heart is
now abazalwana abawathutha abantu kula Kalash imoto zenu uThixo anisikelele.
God bless you, brothers, that are collecting people from Kalash.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. May God bless you till we meet again. Shalom.
Bazalwane, we picked up this last week. Just see the deacons. We've had this Bible for a couple of months, it's almost a year in the church. Amen. Don't leave it next time. Yes. God bless you. This is a big concern. Amen. There's a Bible. Clinton Biao. Bill. Yeah.
praise the sense of the living God as our dear brothers will dismiss us.